Hi, sweetie.
Goodbye, Poppy.
I'm so sorry I can't be there for the recital.
I told you, don't worry. You've been to many of my recitals.
Yeah, but this is different. You're gonna actually be doing the whole recital, not just one or two songs.
Then think about all the other times I've played in, put it together as one, and there you have it.
That's not good enough.
And what would be enough?
Enough would be me being there for you every single special moment. No exceptions. However, I have to work so I could put food on her table. Talking about food, I left some food in the refrigerator, and I also left you some money on the desk. Also, Raymond's gonna be coming with me to the airport to drop me off so you could have the car to move around with.
Thank you, Bob.
I hate leaving you alone.
I'll be fine.
So tell me, how was school today?
It's tiring. Did you know teachers give us homework like we have nothing else to do?
So what else do you have to do in life?
Well, I have to practice music, wash dishes, do laundry, many other things because you won't be here.
Honey, as if you don't have to do all those things already.
Yeah, but I just want time to chill and watch TV.
Honey, you can chill and relax and watch TV when you retire at the age of 65, and maybe by that time it will be more like 85.
Well, I won't worry about that. I'll use your money to retire young.
Where do you get all this stuff from? Okay, honey, I have to go. I'll see you later.
Okay, Poppy. Have a good trip. Behave.
Me behave? No, you behave.
There's no fun in that.
You're so much like your dad. Okay, sweetie, I'll see you next week.
Okay, see you.
Wow, Isabel. How do you feel about this?
I don't know. This whole thing is crazy.
Did your dad read it?
No.
Well, it's addressed to him.
I don't know how to react. He's already stressed out as it is with his job. I don't want to keep adding to that. I guess I can show him later.
Well, in the meantime, what are you going to do?
I don't know. I've always wondered if she was even alive.
Well, now at least we know she is.
You know, sometimes I've thought about how I would react whenever I see her. If I would hate her, forgive her, ignore her, or just completely forgetting about her, making her pay for all of this. You know, that's how I feel.
Well, if you feel that way, you should probably wait until your dad gets back.
So we can beat her up together, right?
Well, that's not exactly what I meant.
Come on, Mike. It's one thing to know that your mother died or that she would come visit you for your birthday or write you a letter. But she didn't even do that. You know, after 16 years not knowing anything about her and she shows up like this, what am I supposed to do?
Well, maybe instead of thinking about what you should do, we should think about what you want to do.
I have no idea how it is to have a mother. When I was younger, my dad would bring his girlfriends home, and I actually liked some of them, but others not too much. I've always wanted a mother who would be there for me and do the things my dad couldn't. The girl stuff, you know? Or someone to look after me while my dad was away. I just wanted a mother who would loved me and whom I would love.
Now you have the chance to get some of that.
I don't know if I can forgive her, Mike.
You can if that's what you want. I mean, she said in her letter that she was sorry she left you and your dad. I mean, how is it gonna help if you hold a grudge against her now?
Thank you. papi?
Hola, bebé. How are you?
Doing great.
Oh, good to hear that.
Have you landed yet?
We did, thank God. We just landed and I'm anxious about getting off this plane.
Yeah, I guess I can see why.
So what are you up to?
Right now I'm doing homework, but I don't really feel like it, so...
Well, sweetheart, you know you have to get it done.
I'm tired.
Well, no more than me. You haven't been on a plane for 4 hours.
I guess. How was the flight?
It was quite good. Everything went well. Hey, did Raymond bring the car?
Yeah, he did.
Great. Hey, sweetheart, I have to go now because I have to get off the plane. Hey, is everything okay there?
Yeah, everything's fine. We have food in the fridge, so.
Oh, yeah. There's food in the fridge. What would you do without me?
Order pizza.
Whatever. Call me before you go to sleep and try not to go to bed too late.
Okay, Bobby. Later.
Take care, sweetie.
You too. Bye. Sorry to be late.
No, I am 16 years late.
You're right.
Thanks for coming, though. I'm so happy to see you.
Were you ever happy before this?
I thought I was, but your dad and I were very young when you were born.
Excuse me, hi. What do you want to drink?
A lemonade, please.
I'd like more water, please.
Alrighty, I'll be back with your drinks.
What happened was that I had other plans, but I wasn't ready to have a child. But I wanted to give it a try because I loved your dad.
You didn't love him enough, and you didn't love me at all.
It's not like that, Isabel.
No.
Explain.
No, don't explain. When you try to explain something that is wrong, it's because you're trying to justify it. And there's no justification for what you did. So don't explain.
Isabel, I'm up to nothing else but wanting my daughter to forgive me. Can you do that?
My father didn't read your letter. I haven't showed him. I don't think he would have reacted nicely.
I know. And how is he doing?
He's great. He struggles a lot, but he has a job at an accounting firm.
Accounting?
Yeah. He got sick of whatever job there was. So he went back to college to become an accountant.
Nice. How about you? Are you in high school?
I'm graduating this year.
Wow.
Dude, we didn't make anything last night. We didn't even sub in the players at all.
Yeah,
I don't have some wrong with them.
No defense. No defense.
Uh-oh, bro.
Is it woman?
Shh. Go say hi to her. Go say hi to her.
Let's go.
We're very happy, as you can see.
Hey, Isabel.
Hey.
Hi.
Hello.
Hey, that recital you told us about, is that still going on?
Yeah, you guys coming?
Yeah, definitely.
Of course we are.
Cool.
All right, we'll see you later.
Okay, later.
A recital? Are you going to sing?
No, I play the flute.
Oh, I love the flute.
Hi, here are your drinks.
ready to order?
I don't know where to think.
No, right now, thanks.
All right, just let me know.
Thank you. It's gonna be this Monday at the auditorium. It's actually two streets down from here, in front of the big gym.
Is your dad going to be there?
No, he's traveling right now because of his job. He's been away a lot lately.
And who do you stay with when he's gone?
By myself.
Isabel, I'm so sorry to hear that.
You should be. You left us. You know, I don't care why you left us. Because I'm not like one of those little kids who think there's something wrong with them. To me, the only thing wrong is you. But I'm curious. Why did you come back and why now?
I repented for what I did many years ago. I just didn't have the courage to show my face. I started to looking for you guys, and I found you 7 months ago. But till now, I wasn't brave enough.
How could you live with this all these years?
I don't know.
So, what made you brave enough that you finally came?
So, do you think you have any siblings?
No.
Your mom probably had you and thought that was enough.
Or maybe she doesn't like men or family.
Maybe. Do you think she wants to make things right with your dad?
Well, if that's what she's going for, then no, I don't think she's gonna get it.
What about you? Are you gonna give her a chance?
This is harder than I thought it would be.
I know. But what did your mom say? And why didn't you let her finish?
Because her explanation was dumb. And I know why she left. It's for her crazy dreams, that's all.
What kind of dreams?
I didn't ask her.
Hello? Oh no, you're at the hospital? Is she gonna be okay? Oh no, don't tell her not to worry about that. No, we can't get another pianist by now. But you tell her not to worry. No, see? Yeah, I know, it'll break Isabel's heart, but we just don't have a choice. We'll just postpone the recital. Thanks so much for the call. Tell her we're praying for her. Okay, bye-bye.
Hi, Jenny.
Isabel.
How are you?
Oh, not so good. I just got a phone call from Anna's husband, and she's been taken to the hospital with an asthma attack.
What? No way. Is she gonna be fine?
He says that they've gone through this before, that she's gonna be okay, but they're gonna keep her overnight for observation.
So no pianist?
I'm sorry, it looks like we're gonna have to postpone.
Can't you play?
Well, I wish I could, but I don't play well enough to justify the hard work that you've put into it. I would ruin your recital.
It's okay, I'll just have to live with it.
I'm so sorry. Hello?
Hi, I'm sorry to interrupt.
What are you doing here?
I came for your recital.
It's in 2 hours, or it was.
I was wandering outside and I overheard that you don't have a pianist.
Yeah, we might have to postpone.
Isabel, I don't know how comfortable you feel with this, but I'd like to play the accompaniment for you.
You play the piano?
I'm a composer. Music is what I do best.
Well, do you really think you could do it? We only have 2 hours.
If you give me the music sheets, we can do it.
I've got them right here. They're all, hold on, they're all here, set, ready to roll. Right here.
Thank you.
Isabel, if your friend can pull this off, your recital will be saved.
I sure hope so.
Don't just hope, trust. Are you ready?
Yes.
What, you finally remembered you had a daughter?
Danny!
Where have you been all these years? Where were you when she needed you the most? Huh?
Danny, please forgive me.
What, you suddenly have a heart? You left without an explanation. You left without ever looking back. What did I do to you? What did she do to you? Worst of all, what kind of mother abandons her baby? I loved you. Do you even know what that is?
Yes, I know.
No, you don't know. You don't because you can't love. You abandoned us. We were a family. Why did you leave us?
It was not what I wanted.
What didn't you want?
A family.
What? Are you crazy?
I was crazy.
And you're still crazy. If there's something worse, it's for you to reappear after all these years and act like nothing ever happened.
I was desperate. I was too young.
That doesn't excuse you, Delma. You talk about young. How old was she? You know, you left and you never looked back. I left our country in order to forget everything about you. But how could I? When raising our daughter without a mother.
I went back looking for you. But they didn't want to tell me where you were. Did they tell you that?
Of course not, because they knew that the moment they did, I'd probably be more bitter than the day you left us.
Hi. Good job, proud of you.
Thank
Isabel,
you.
That was so good.
Thank you.
Good job.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Hey, you're so beautiful.
Have you seen the pianist in the garage?
I think she went outside. Though.
Okay, thanks.
Then you come back here and play piano with her like if nothing ever happened. Does she even know the witch that's playing the piano with?
Danny, please, I'm just asking you to forgive me.
Forgive you? Would that change the past? Will that take you back to being the mother that you never were to my daughter? You abandoned her, innocent and vulnerable. And now, you expect her just to forgive you? Isabella, go get your things. We're leaving right now. And I'm not gonna tell you again.
Dad, I wanna talk.
No, it's not a good time.
If we could just try.
I said no, now go to bed.
If you forgive others for the wrongs they do to you, then your Father in heaven will also forgive your wrongs. But if you don't forgive others, then your Father in heaven will not forgive the wrongs you do.
So we have to forgive everybody?
I wouldn't say we have to. It's more like, if God forgives us, we become so happy that we want to do the same for others.
Oh, I see. Papi, if Mommy comes back, we will forgive her, right? Right, Papi?
Isabel? Isabel!
To any of my texts.
I think it's better if I just leave now.
Thought you know what to do, just run away from your problems?
I wanted to set things right.
You're not trying hard enough. Who knows how much time you have left? You're dying. You've been gone for 16 years. You gotta make those up. The reason why you left is for your crazy dreams, right? Did they come true?
Yes, but that didn't make me happy.
Why? It was what you wanted.
But I wasn't there to share with you. Selfish.
And you came looking for another chance, right?
Yes.
I want that chance too. Dad, I'm sorry. I already made my decision. We can't change the past, but we can change the future. I want to forgive her. Thelma, I forgive you.
Thelma, we have lots to talk about.
I'm ready when you're ready.
I'm actually on my way back home. You still like your breakfast the way you used to? Scrambled eggs with cheese?
Still my favorite.